Hey everybody, welcome back to another Heroic Wednesday with Let's Play and Chill. As always, I'm your host Justin, and today I want to be trying out Karazim, the Diablo Monk, partly because he is very close to leveling. And I don't think I've played a healer in a while for the channel, so if you want to skip ahead, there'll be a timestamp down below letting you skip to that in the descriptions. But like always, we're going to go over his abilities really quick. So first off, with his trait, you have actually three choices, which are your level one ability, which are right here. So I guess we should talk about those really quick. So first off, you have Transcendence. Each of these kind of have a similar theme of activating on your third basic attack. So with Transcendence, every third basic attack heals the lowest nearby... Oh, that's different. No, that always worked at lowest. Every third basic attack heals the lowest nearby ally for a small amount and gives 25% movement speed for 2 seconds. That's pretty good. Pretty good. Iron Fist, if you want to go more damage, which I tried out once, it was kind of interesting. Not my go-to, but it has its place. Every third basic attack deals 110% bonus damage and gives 25% movement increase. Did not know about the movement speed increase. So yeah, every third auto attack, you deal a little bit more than double damage, which is pretty good. And an increased move. And then we have Insight, which is the one we are going to be doing today, which has a quest built into it. So every third auto attack, you regenerate mana and gain a stack of insight. Sorry, still feeling a little sick. My throat's all jacked up. So you gain a stack of insight. You also get a 25% increased movement speed. I did not know that about any of these, and I play him a fairly good little bit. And insight. Upon gaining 100 insight, every third auto attack you do reduces your ability cooldowns by 1.75 seconds. And if I remember correctly, because it says it says basic abilities. Never mind. But yeah. So you get you're incentivized with this one to attack your enemies, attack anything with an enemy health bar. You gain mana back, and you're reducing the cooldown of all of your abilities besides your heroic, which we'll now go over all of his abilities. So with this Q, you have Radiant Dash. Use this to jump to an enemy or ally unit. Enemies are immediately hit with a basic attack. Stores up to 2 charges. Pretty decent, used for either engage or escape. And then you have Breath of Heaven with your W, which is heals nearby heroes for some health and gives them 15 movement speed for 3 seconds. Maybe it was an update. I don't know if he's always had this movement speed increase. I just could be dumb. And then his E ability, Deadly Reach. Karazim's next basic attacks increase his... Wait. Karazim's next basic attack increases his attack speed and attack range by 100% for 2 seconds. So I feel like that's worded a little weird, but... So what you could do is you hit your E and you charge up Deadly Reach. So as soon as you start attacking somebody, yeah, you have doubled your attack speed and you can attack a little farther. He's a melee character, so yeah, it's weird. You'll see the animation and that'll let you know how far you go or your attacks can go. Now you have his two heroic abilities. Each are pretty good. If we are the only healer, I think we're gonna go Divine Palm. If not, we might go Seven-Sided Strike. Seven-Sided Strike, you become invulnerable and strike 7 times over 2 seconds. Each strike hits the highest health. Oh, I didn't know that it was the highest health. I thought it was just random. The highest health nearby hero, enemy hero, for 7% of their maximum health. So if you can get a single character isolated, hit 7 times 7, that's almost 50% of their health gone just like that. Pretty good. And then you have Divine Palm, which you protect an ally from death, causing them to be... So you put this protective aura on an ally, and as soon as they were to normally have died, they are momentarily stunned instead of dying, and then instantly take that massive heal that you see there. And this is level 1 numbers. Let's get to killing.
Guide my path.
Alright, everybody, we find ourselves on Braxis Holdout today. Level 1, we're going to take Insight. We already talked about that.
Are the minions of hell stronger?
So, friendly team.
Defeat them, nonetheless.
We have Thrall, Karazim, Sylvanas, Vala, and Chromie. With the enemy team, Nazebo, Gul'dan, Murky, Liming, and Stukov.
10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So, this is going to be an interesting game. Everybody's ranged on the enemy team. And me and...
I go.
Okay, so... that was an interesting engagement. Did not expect the Chromie Hourglass there. Should have been paying attention a little bit more. Activate Prime R E ability. Oh, almost got the Stuka off, but just out of range just a little bit. Trying to also adjust my mic. Been kind of all over the place.
The gods are in awe.
I'm healing.
Energizing. Oh. You have to control them.
Back up a little bit, Gul'dan some healing. We don't want that. Alright, keep the enemy team healed up. Chromie looks like she's doing some work over there. Just missed a little bit. Jump to Chromie, get out of the Gul'dan's health thing. Oh, I walked right into that. I like a dumbass.
Please let this work.
Get the health globe. Heal the team up a bit. Get some stacks going. We are already at 10 out of the 100 stacks we need. Heal the Vala. Go. Yes. Let them know I am going this way. Heal Thrall.
You shall be defeated.
Health globe. Oh. Now we get the health globe.
The gods are in
Looks
all
like
things.
We might need to go up this way. Murky up there. Enemy team is missing. There's Murky. That's fine. We'll just leave him.
Where is my foe? You.
Okay, we got him taken down pretty easily. Thrall, come to me. Thrall, come to me. There you go.
Choose a talent.
And level 4, we are going to go Spirit Ally, which is a souped up healing totem. Keep trying to pressure that Murky away. Ooh, just avoided the Stuke off. Got a fight going on here, so. Okay. Try and jump on him. Stuke off there. Take him down. Jump on the Murky. Take him down. That's good, good, good. And just go back to fighting minions. Try and get up our stacks. Should have jumped over and healed Thrall. I didn't. Primary E, attack this tower. Shift over to the wall because it has a good little bit of health and it gives us free stacks. You'll throw all up.
The battle draws near.
Oh, Murky's on his own again. Should have waited for me to activate that E when he bubbled, but looks like with help of Thrall, we take him down. We heal him up again. Oh, take down Li Ming.
Excellent. The enemy will have to deal with a much larger wave of Zerg than we will.
Jump Thrall, heal him up.
Killing spree.
Your flaws are revealed.
Choose a talent.
Heal everybody up a bit. Get our auto attacks going. We are gonna go Blazing Fist at level 7, which every third basic attack reduces the cooldown of our deadly reach, making it so we can attack faster even more. Getting our stacks up faster, increasing our cooldown reduction once we get to that point. See this wall, and we're just gonna go for that. Get some easy stacks.
I go.
I am well again.
Yeah.
Your flaws are revealed.
We're gonna go. Well, we're gonna go to the bottom lane and see if we can help the Chromie and Li Ming. As we take down Murky again for the fifth time, fourth time? I don't know. Too many times. Kill up Ravala there.
The Zerg are eliminated. Huh. Jump into the cool
band.
I knew I could rely on you.
Ooh, barely avoided that. Leave, 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 leave. Keep our party pretty healthy.
The gods are in all things.
They don't have a wall for me to attack. We could get this though.
Let us capture this monster swarm.
So, Vala, heal her up.
Here we go.
And
we'll be pleased.
Have we died? We've died once. We're not dying too much, so I guess seven-sided strike. We're gonna jump in here, use that. Not get it too often. Heal Vala. Stay in the way of any attacks coming in. Try and get some mana so we can heal Vala up again. There we go. Good job, Chromie. Good job, everybody. Almost walked into the zombie wall. Not good there. Heal everybody up. Keep everybody nice, alive, and healthy. Gotta get this globe though. Jump to the Chromie so we're back in the fray of things. Just barely missed that other health globe. Stukov trying to slow us down, but
looks
we
like
are the monk, we don't care. Jump in on Nazebo. Ah, screw that up. But we're gonna get out of it and not be affected too much by that.
Enemy down.
Oh, follow back up, follow back up. There we go, you healed. Whoa! Shit. Good kill, Chromie. Good kill, Chromie. I should have healed myself. I should have healed myself there. That would have saved me. Yep. Enemy team should be coming up here, but we have two of their forces there.
I serve once more.
Gonna let the team know we're coming down to the bottom one. Enemy team has their heroics. We are keeping up with Stukov in healing, falling just a little bit behind. Actually, we're gonna head up here now because the half of the enemy team is there. The ones that are alive. Gonna take down most of them. And there we go. Drop that there, he'll thrall up a good bit. And just like that, we're doing pretty well. Chromie, no! I gotta hit things. Let's see. We are going to go Fist of Fury, increasing the duration of our fists. Okay, I wanted to be closer to Thrall anyway. Oh, I messed that up. Thrall, stay in the green, man.
You have my thanks.
There we go, that's all of the healing I got for you guys.
My mind is clear.
Jump on the Li Ming. Take her down. Going back, he'll Thrall, he'll Chromie. And with the deadly reach duration, as soon as we get our cooldown reduction, we can pretty much attack with the deadly reach indefinitely. Oh, so close. Ooh, good Sunder. Good Sunder. This might be game. It's probably game. Place the green man there. Go ham on the core. Jump the Thrall, heal him up. And escape. Jump the Chromie. Nope. Why would you go back in? You could have got away. Why would you go back in? Pointless death. He might have died, I don't know.
Field research is so exciting, they said.
But if we can get some camps.
I'll show them some excitement.
I don't know how this is going with Vala. Not great. But we're back up, so we can help the team grab our two camps on our side. We do have a level advantage, so it's going pretty good for us.
Your strength.
And there we go, there's our cooldown reduction. And we can, in situations like this, we can just keep our deadly reach up indefinitely and get massive cooldown reduction and keep everybody healthy for a long, long time. We should be grouping.
The gods are in all things.
Yeah, let's keep pushing this down. They should have seen this coming, but they didn't. It's up to Sylvanas. And just keep punching the core. Jump to Sylvanas, heal her up. Put the green man down. No! Put himself up. I'm silenced. Jump to Sylvanas.
Here we go again.
And we get away.
The
healing. Yes. Heal. We did a little bit of core damage, but not enough. I couldn't have done anything with Thrall there. I had no healing and was low on health.
You unlocked the talent.
Heal up Sylvanas.
I go.
Yeah, and
make haste toward the beacons.
We're gonna just keep on with the high. Oh boy. Oh, I was too back to do anything. Ah, stupid me. Stupid. Ah, run. Prime that. Can we get Leeming? Woo! Let's all go. Let's try and get through that poison. Oh, there's Murky's egg. Damn it!
Time for a break. Enemy deleted.
Still, the balance is kept.
That was stupid on my part. I should have backed out. But friendly team does manage to take out Murky. And was that Stukov? That was Stukov. Cool. They should be able to get that fight. And they did. Good job them.
My time has not yet come.
I'm gonna go down to help Chromie try and fight off this Gul'dan. And possibly Murky.
The battle draws near.
Just die! Ah.
Whoa, that was cool.
The battle draws near.
God, what was that? How did he? What, how was he so tanky? That. I wasted my ult. I'm a genius.
Burn, baby, burn.
Yes.
Alright, going up to try and help Chromie. She's backing with Bye Bye. We could grab. Nope. Objectives aren't up yet, so. Or going yet, I guess. Fuck off, Li Ming!
Yes.
You have my defense for now.
Alright, maybe we can turn this around. Looks like that was not actually Chroma's egg. Okay. And nope, Chromie's get taken down because she was off on her own.
I serve once more.
Try and see if we can get the Thrall. I don't know if he can win that fight. Looks like he can win that fight. I don't agree with him using Sunder there, but. See if we can get this new Zeo.
Well.
as we can punish them a little. God, fuck you! Fuck you and your goddamn push! That's frustrating. We had a good start, now we're just falling apart. How? What the hell is the cooldown on that? 20 sec. That's bullshit. That needs to be increased.
The enemy just destroyed a fort.
That should not be a 20 second cooldown. Alright, we got our E ability primed. If we can jump in on any of those, avoid any thing they have.
Hello. Your base is being attacked by the Zerg.
Stay in the healing circle. Stay in the healing circle. Can't really do much there. Yep.
Zerg threat eliminated.
We are gonna go Storm Shield with this one to try and help us with team fights a little bit more.
I welcome a new trial.
They're all down here, so if my team comes out and helps me, or not, we're gonna go help them because we're the healer. So. Fucking kidding me, guys. Yeah, I'm coming. Shut up. I'm coming. Just trying to avoid the enemy team.
You shall be defeated.
Enemy down.
There we go. That's heals we wanted. Fuck you. Everyone on their team has a fucking displacement. Are you kidding me? Alright, let's just focus down the damn core. Keep everyone. That was not 20 seconds. What the hell?
Yes.
Killing spree over.
I have many lives. That one was well spent.
Just hit the fucking core, please.
Killing spree.
Thank you. Thank you.
Beacons are recharging.
Yeah, that was a little bit of a cluster. I screwed up, but a good little bit, but
GG.
One. Too bad we won the game. Had actually pretty decent healing. Could have been better. Could have kept the team alive more if we would have gone Divine Palm. Should have expected the Stukov push with. Yeah, he was saving. Felt like he was saving that for me, but when it's off cooldown all the damn time, can't really do much. But we leveled up. Got a win. Showed you guys a video. We'll get to the crate in a second. If you guys want to follow along with the talents today. Who was this? If you guys want to follow along today with the talents that we chose, we have Insight, Spirit Ally, Blazing Fists, Seven Sided Strike. Should have gone Divine Palm, but it still worked out. Fists of Fury, Way of 100 Fists, and Storm Shield. And yeah, I guess we'll open the crate and then call it a video. So got new portrait, got a voice line we already had, and a new skin. So I guess we'll keep that. Gotta keep the gold so we can get new characters when they come out. If you guys liked that video, subscribe to the channel. Yeah, subscribe to the channel. Follow us Facebook and Twitter. There's links down for that below. Share it with your friends on whatever you can share it with. And yeah, see you guys next time.